The IDDSI flow test. In this video, you'll see the results of experiments and simulations of the flow inside the test to understand how it works. Hello, I'm Ben Hansen, and I'm delighted to present our latest research publication. This paper has been peer-reviewed and published in the journal Annals of Biomedical Engineering. It's available free of charge thanks to the support of my employer, UCL, and the work was funded by the United States National Institutes of Health. Professor Steele and myself are members of the voluntary board of IDDSI, which in 2017 published its framework with an objective flow test for classifying the thickness of liquids. Flow behaviour of liquids is not always easy to define. For very simple liquids, we can measure viscosity based on Newton's laws. But most liquids in the real world don't follow that idealised relationship. The thicker liquids we see in foods and drinks, including those designed for management of dysphagia, have a more interesting non-Newtonian nature. Usually they're shear thinning, which means that their apparent viscosity becomes lower as they're pushed harder to flow faster. Some thicker liquids also have a yield stress, which means that the fluid won't flow at all unless it's pushed with a stress greater than the yield stress. In this study, we included a range of liquids from Newtonian glycerol mixtures to gum-based thickened liquids. We measured them at a range of shear rates relevant to swallowing using a laboratory rheometer. The results showed that the thickened liquid's apparent viscosity sometimes changed by a factor of several hundred times depending on the test shear rate. So immediately we can see that a measurement of apparent viscosity can't categorize the relative thickness of different types of liquids. There needs to be a more holistic measure of flow behaviour. The IDDSI flow test was designed to provide a 0 to 10 scale of the consistency of liquids. In rheology, the shear rate is usually precisely controlled, but when a person swallows, the bolus of liquid experiences a wide range of shear rates in different locations and times. Even though a syringe is a relatively simple shape, no one had yet published an equation or map of the shear rates or flow patterns inside. So the main focus of this study was to investigate the flow within the IDDSI flow test. Mathematical approximations had previously been found to be too simplified, so we had to create a detailed computational model. We made a series of refinements until the overall result of the simulation matched the experimental result. We could then have confidence that the simulation was a good description of the flow within the test. We used industry standard ANSYS software with an enhancement to account for cases where the fluid was dripping rather than streaming from the nozzle. Experimentally, we wanted to measure how the liquid was draining during the flow test, as well as getting a reliable measure of the final liquid level at 10 seconds. So we created a rig which used video and motion tracking software to plot the liquid level versus time. Here are some results comparing the simulated and measured liquid level over the 10 seconds of the flow test. Because the flow is gravity-driven, the level falls fastest when the syringe is full at the start and then slows as the liquid level drops. When the syringe is full, the maximum pressure is around 0.7 kilopascals, but even this low pressure is enough to cause the liquids to flow quickly. In most cases, the simulated flow matched the experiments well, but the largest discrepancy was with gum-based liquids. We thought this could be due to the gum liquids having a significant viscoelastic behaviour, which makes them more cohesive than the others in practice. The purpose of creating the computer simulation was to calculate the flow within the syringe. Since each section of the syringe is cylindrical like a pipe, in all cases the flow speed is maximum in the centre of the channel, decreasing to zero at the edges where the fluid is effectively sticking to the stationary walls. The Newtonian liquids we tested showed the classic parabolic profile. The thickened liquids, particularly the gum-based liquids, show what's called a plug-like profile, where the central volume of liquid has relatively more constant velocity and the flow decreases down to stationary over just a small region near the walls. It's this non-uniform, non-Newtonian flow that's thought to give rise to the slippery feeling of gum-based liquids. And there are some recent investigations about whether gum-based liquids can be more cohesive and whether that might be beneficial for swallowing. Here are some of our results for flow speed of level 1 liquids in the syringe nozzle. The speeds are comparable to those measured during swallows, and that's with a driving pressure which is much lower than the peak pressures measured during swallowing. So the pressure needed to swallow thick liquids is not necessarily very high. Shear rate is the slope of those graphs. It's the change in velocity across the width of the cylinder. It's always highest at the walls and always decreases to zero right at the centre of the liquid flow. In the cases of plug-like flow, the shear rate in the centre of the flowing channel is relatively low, as the central bulk of fluid is moving almost as one. But then the shear rate really increases in the regions near the walls. The results shown here are for liquids with the same thickness measurement on the IDDSI flow test, so the volume of flow during the 10 seconds was the same in each case. When we compare these two different types of liquids, there are two important features. First, there's no one shear rate which can describe what's going on. Even in the Newtonian case, the shear rate is always a range from zero in the centre to a maximum at the boundary between liquid and the solid surface. Secondly, that range of shear rates is greater for highly shear thinning liquids. Near the boundaries, the shear rate is higher, but through the bulk of the fluid, the shear rate would be very low. Those two features apply in any flow situation, whether that's in a lab measurement or when someone's swallowing. So in summary, the IDDSI flow test is a measurement of how fast liquids flow under gravity. We found that the flow and shear rates can be fast even under a low gravitational pressure. We've also visualised how the flow speed and pattern varies through the cross-section, showing a range of shear rates which depends on the type of liquid as well as its thickness. The simulations were based on shear rheology models of the liquids, and by including a very wide range of shear rates in the simulation, we were able to closely match the experimental flow test results. There was some mismatch with the gum-based liquids, and we thought that was likely due to them having a viscoelastic behaviour and cohesion. Those characteristics weren't captured by shear rheology, but they do seem to have an impact on fluid behaviour and the IDDSI test result. So as a reminder, the detailed methods and results are available open access in the Annals of Biomedical Engineering, and we'd encourage you to visit www.idsi.org for further details of the flow test.